Hi, I'm Michael Kiwanuka, and you're watching 101.9 KINK Radio in the Skype live studio.
It's really good to see you. You're going to play the soundtrack from the opening credits of Big Little Lies, and I just finished the series.
Cool.
What does that mean for an artist when they choose you for a series that's going to be as breakout big as that series has been?
Yes, it's huge. It's you know, for an artist, you know, you always just want people to hear what you're doing, and there's not always the avenues to do that. You have the radio and stuff, but sometimes, just for whatever reason, certain songs don't get on the radio, and so you just kind of go and you promote it. But when you get something like that, it just opens your music to so many more people that may not hear it, you know, that are fans of the actors on the show. Or so for me, I definitely was excited when that happened, and I could feel the difference straight away after the first time that came out, you know.
I have this vision of me getting in a car like Reese Witherspoon and putting on Michael Kiwanuka and driving down the Pacific Coast Highway. Are you going to do that too?
Yeah. I wanted to. I was seeing the credits. It was a lot of people have said that, you know, with the drive and just the scenery and stuff. But yeah, it's really cool, and especially with music like that song. It's not like the song's long, and it's got all these things that aren't necessarily used for like a hit song or anything like that, so it felt like it was on the radio all the time, especially on a program like that with all those, you know, cool actors, like watching Nicole Kidman since I was, you know, a kid and stuff like that. So
yeah, no
cool.
Kidding.
Yeah,
we talked about a little bit of your childhood growing up in London and some of your musical influences, and it was so crazy that it ranged all the way from punk to jazz to soul to R&B.
Yeah,
and I'm very curious whether or not you've ever really defined what genre of music you are, because it encompasses all of those influences.
Yeah. I mean, you know, anything for me, anything that was soulful I liked, but it wouldn't matter if it was kind of like overdriven, like Nirvana style or grunge music, or if it was folk or like quote unquote like horn style outswelling soul, whatever that had like a good feeling to it, or gave me goosebumps, whatever I liked. So yeah, you can find that in any kind of music, but I guess I was just trying to find my way, and still am, you know. Sometimes I feel like listening to heavy rock, sometimes I like listening to just mellow folk acoustic, you know, as long as it's got that feeling to it.
I love the story that you actually decided to become a singer when you realized Jimi Hendrix was black.
Yeah.
Was there a time that you were thinking, here's a white guy doing this?
No, it's just, it was just because it was a different, you know, I didn't relate to, you know, the R&B at the time. So like early 2000s, late 90s, it was like, you know, no disrespect to them. I love their music, but Usher or that wasn't me, you know. Or like, do you remember Casey and JoJo stuff like that? They had like that amazing song that was yeah, great tunes, but I couldn't do that. So I was like, oh, you know, I don't. Me and my electric guitar and listen to Kurt Cobain, who's I just don't really fit the sound of that. And then I saw Hendrix on TV, and he was playing this heavy rock guitar and singing this rock and roll with this soulful feeling. I was like, well, that's pretty cool. I want to be, now I can do it, you know. Wow. Funny story, but that's what happened.
Yeah, it's awesome. You also started out as a session guitarist, and there must have been a moment where somebody said, Michael, that voice. When was that moment?
Well, I never sang during the sessions, but I sent a demo in on the days of MySpace. Does anyone remember MySpace? People showing their age if they know MySpace, I guess. And I sent a demo through not through MySpace, but I found this like production company through MySpace, and sent a song that I'd written, and it was meant to be for like, I just said, you know, I've just started writing songs. If you know any singers and they were connected, maybe I could write with you, or they could use this song. And then they emailed back like a day later saying, man, oh, it's a cool song, but have you thought of singing it yourself? And I said, well, I'll give it a go. And then we had some sessions, and then people responded really well. I thought, oh, this is cool. I guess I'll sing. But I didn't know, you know. I'd never really sung that much in public or recorded myself that much, you know. So it was lucky that happened.
I read that your mom was a house cleaner, mm-hmm. and that she still cleans houses. There must have been a moment when you said, Mom, well, that's okay. That's not necessary. What was that conversation like?
Oh, man. I'm still, you know. I'm definitely not earning the massive bucks just yet to buy in houses. But I'm hoping now, especially with his second album and things like Big Little Lies, she doesn't have to do that as much. And I know she wants to go and go back to Uganda and live there and stuff. So hopefully that can happen pretty soon. But she's really excited. She comes to all the London shows and checks everything out online and follows everything. So she's biggest supporter, biggest fan. So it's pretty cool.
I really love that you were flexible enough to let us talk during this time. So just take the music straight on through. Michael Kiwanuka, everyone.
Thank you.